If you aren't sure where to start when integrating Oxylabs Scraper APIs into your infrastructure, this video is for you. I will explain three primary Scraper APIs integration methods, their key advantages, and give some usage tips. Integration is the process of incorporating a web scraping service into the entire pipeline that a company uses to scrape and parse web data. The integration method is how you interact with scraping software and how you get your data delivered. All integration methods fall under two major categories, synchronous and asynchronous. Take a phone call service as an example. Imagine you give me a call asking to scrape some web data. I hear your request and go to process the job. As I complete the job, let's say 10 seconds after I started, I return the results while still on the same phone call and then end the call. This is an example of a synchronous method. In this case, you must keep the connection open once you send your job request so that I can return the results when the job is done. Sending a request and getting the results happen on the same connection. The synchronous integration method works differently. Continuing the same analogy, you make a short phone call to me describing the job that needs to be done. I reply immediately, confirming that the job is registered with a particular job ID. The call ends here, and the connection is closed. When I complete the job, I make another short call to the phone number you left while registering, letting you know the job is done. And now you can download the results. Alternatively, you can check the job status yourself by calling me again. The critical point here is that sending a job request and downloading the results happen on separate connections, allowing you to use the line for other calls in the meantime. Now, after hearing the analogy, you might be wondering what's the difference between integration method and data delivery method. Well, overall, both refer to the same concept. However, depending on how you approach it, the data delivery method can signify a more narrow term. It refers to the data delivery process, which is an essential component of the synchronous method only, while the asynchronous method allows downloading data at the client's initiative too. Tell me about your struggles when dealing with public data collection in the comments below, and consider subscribing if you would like us to address them in upcoming videos. You can integrate Oxylabs Scraper APIs in three ways: Realtime, Proxy Endpoint, and Push-Pull. Realtime is a synchronous method. You have to maintain the connection open from the moment you submit your job until we return the results of a successfully completed job or an error. To submit a request, you need to provide a JSON file describing the job that needs to be done and include fields such as source, geolocation, query, and so on. Note that the JSON needed for the job submission in real time is unique to our service and requires some additional knowledge. Read our documentation linked in the video description below to learn more. Similarly to real time, the proxy endpoint integration method is synchronous and, for the most part, works in the same way. The biggest difference is how you provide the initial job request information. With this method, you use our Scraper API endpoint as a proxy server. Unlike real time, instead of a JSON, you should provide a URL and some headers or cookies you would like to pass on to the target you want to scrape. Note that if you are already familiar with proxies and how they work, you might want to opt for this integration method due to its convenience and ease of use. All you need to do is change the proxy address in use and we'll do the rest. In this case, the proxy endpoint method requires the least changes on the client side. Unlike real-time and proxy endpoints, push-pull is an asynchronous integration method. With the push-pull data delivery methods, you don't have to keep an open connection. Instead, you can wait for the job to be complete so you can retrieve the result at your own convenience. In addition to downloading the results, it's possible to check the job status. Similar to real-time, you need to submit a JSON file with the job description. if you include a callback URL in your job description, once the job is done, we will post a message to your callback server saying that the job has been completed. And then you can go ahead and download the results within the next 24 hours. Compared to other integration methods, push-pull is a bit more complex, but offers richer functionality. Here are some nuances to remember. Single query allows you to submit a job within a single job query. Once your job is submitted, we give you your job ID and a couple of URLs. One where you can check your job status and the other where you can download the results. You can choose either of the two options. With push-pull, you can send a single request to your system with up to 1,000 scraping jobs you'd like to execute. As a response to a batch query, you'll get the respective number of job IDs. These jobs are done independently of one another. In most cases, when you provide a callback URL, you don't want it to be accessible by anyone on the internet. You only want your scraping service provider to access it to send the information about the job completion. In this case, you need a list of IP addresses you would accept connections from. Since you can easily get the IP addresses of our notifier services, you can easily include them in your allow list. If you want the results to be uploaded to your storage, you should specify where you want to get the results delivered in your job description. This way, you don't need to actively download any data, which makes the process easier and more efficient. Note that push-pull is the better method if you strive for higher scalability to fetch big data volumes. Now let's outline the similarities and differences between each method and what they have to offer. On average, synchronous methods, real-time and proxy endpoints, are easier to implement and use. However, the need to keep the connection open all the time drains more infrastructure resources. On the other hand, push-pull is harder to implement but offers better scalability and more helpful features. This method doesn't require many infrastructure resources, but you would need to invest some engineering resources at the implementation stage. If you don't mind going the hard way, consider push-pull. It's perfect for scaling up and offers useful features such as job status checks and storage delivery. To avoid the hassle, you can pick real-time or proxy endpoint. To delve deeper into the technical details of each integration method, follow a link to our documentation in the video description below. Also, check an introductory video to Scraper APIs to overview functionality. And remember that you can try all of our Scraper APIs for free. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you next time.